Hey, welcome to Milroy United Methodist Church. As you can tell, today we're doing something different. We're worshiping on the lawn. It's a way that we can actually be outside and sing. And if you didn't want to wear a mask, it could be optional. And it's just sometimes nice to be out in God's creation. And this is just a lovely day. So, once again, I really appreciate everybody who's here. Because like I've said several times recently, I know there are temptations out there to pull you away, and you made God a priority today. And I appreciate that, and I know that it is appreciated by God also. We have just one announcement I want to share. Most of them are in your bulletin. You can see on the back of your bulletin several announcements. But what I want to share is July 20th through the 24th. There is 5 days of prayer. It will be from 6 to 7 p.m. Do I need to use my mic? Can you guys hear? I'll use it anyway. Is that better? Okay, from 6 to 7 p.m. at the Conservation Club on East 44, bring a lawn chair, and there's going to be 5 days of prayer. It's very simple. We'll have some music, a pastor each day. We'll just say something very small to introduce the prayer. And then we will sit and pray for a period of time, not out loud, just praying as the body of Christ. And then when we're done, I think we do another song, and then we'll close it. So it's not gonna be, you know, real long, but it is gonna be a time when we all can come together as the body of Christ, multiple denominations, it's a non-denominational service, and pray. So July 20th through the 24th from 6 to 7, put that on your calendar. You can add to that.
If anybody sees it on Facebook or social media, we'd appreciate if you share it. It just gets out to that many more people.
Okay, so once you see the events, go ahead and share them. All the events are on our Facebook page as individual events, so you can share those out. I've been sharing it also. I know Susie has. We just want to get word out. We just think this is a good time for us to come together and pray as the body of Christ. Was there anything else that we needed to share today that wasn't already in the bulletin? Okay. Our call to worship is from our psalm. Your word is a lamp to our feet and a light to our path. Your word is our heritage forever, the joy of our hearts. So would you please stand at this time and join, if you are able, you don't have to stand, if you are able, stand as we do a prayer. Author of life, the living word, holy breath, we have stumbled throughout this week and groped our way back to this place today. Illumine the steps before us and write your word on our hearts, for we carry the name of Jesus and would walk in the light of his love. In Jesus' name we humbly pray. Amen. You may be seated. Our first hymn, and we're doing it a cappella, right? Who's going to be leading us? You want to online?
No.
It'll be easier for the people online to hear, though.
Yeah.
It will.
All right.
Because you're kind of soft, you're kind of a soft singer. Open my eyes that I may see, and the words are in your bulletin.
Open my eyes that I may see glimpses of truth thou hast for me. Place in my hands the wonderful key that shall unclasp and set me free. Silently now I wait for thee, ready, my God, thy will to see. Open my eyes, illumine me, Spirit. Voices of truth. truth thou sendest clear. And while the wave notes fall on my ear, everything else will disappear. Silently now I wait for thee, ready, my God, thy will to see. Open my ears, illumine me, Spirit divine. Open my mouth and let me bear gladly the warm truth everywhere. Open my heart and let me prepare love with thy children thus to share. Silently now I wait for thee, ready, my God, thy will to see. Open my heart, illumine me, Spirit divine.
The sun is moving with us. Not a bad thing. It just went away now. You know, as we continue to pray for those on our prayer list, we have several on our prayer list. We've added a few this week. I mentioned Sarah Campbell last week. We also want to lift up Carolina and Sam. Carolina and Sam, as they prepare for their wedding. Probably ought to lift up Mike and Laura too. And also for the teachers and the school staff and all the people who are making decisions on how we're going to move forward in the days ahead. You'll notice the announcements. We're going to delay Wacky Wednesday starting. We want to see how this plays out. I just don't feel we could risk our teachers and the kids in this building. So we're going to be delaying that. Did you guys have anything else you wanted to add to our prayer list? I forgot a pen, but I could get one. Okay. Well, then let's go to the Lord in prayer. Holy God, we were yours before we drew breath, and still we will be yours when the pulse of life passes. In every fragile, reckless moment, we belong to you. We thank you for the desire of our parents who gave us life. May the love we have received spill gratitude from our hearts. May the wounds we carry open our hearts to the needs of others. May we recognize in your mercy the faithfulness that judges and redeems every human bond. We lift to you now all that seems irreconcilable in our families, in our schools and workplaces, in our nation, in your church, and in your world. We pray for those we identify as leaders in every sphere of life. We pray for our nation's leadership and for all whose decisions weigh heavily on others. We pray today for all of those on our prayer list and those we recently added. Please pour out your mercy on them today. In addition, Lord, give us the courage to name ourselves as those whose responsibility is great. Teach us to act, to lovingly react, to tend the world you love, to sow more than we reap, to to heal more than we wound, to make room for others as you made room for us. Redeeming God, stake your claim upon us now until we hear your gospel echo in each stranger's story and see your image reflected in every wounded face. For we pray in the name of Jesus Christ, who unsettles our lives for the sake of your love. And now, as the children of God, let us pray the prayer your Son taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Now, as you came in, you probably saw we've got plates in different areas, so I hope you were able to drop your tithe in then. If you haven't done so, do so now. Because we bring our gifts because tendrils of God's love has worked their ways into our lives and into the soil of our hearts. Sisters and brothers, let us yield our lives to God's abundant harvest. And at this time, if the ushers would pick up the plates, thank you. And if you're comfortable to do so, please stand for the doxology. Praise God, from whom all blessings flow. Praise him, all creatures here below. Praise him above, ye heavenly host. Praise Father, Son, and Holy Ghost. Amen. Thank you. Giver of life, receive these gifts that are before us and before those who are listening online. May they be tokens of our lives. We ask you to send your cultivating spirit to work among us until we yield and grow in grace. For we pray in the name of Jesus Christ, and all God's people say, Amen. You may be seated.
Join us as we sing.
Still we are the voice in the desert crying.
the days.
And these are the days of Ezekiel. The dry bones becoming as flesh. And these are the days of your servant David rebuilding the temple of praise. And these are the days of the harvest. The fields are as wide in the world. And we are the laborers in your vineyard, declaring the word of the Lord. Behold, he comes, riding on the clouds, shining like the sun. At the trumpet call, so lift your voice. It's a year of jubilee, and out of Zion's hill salvation comes. There's no God like Jehovah. 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 Shining like the sun, and the trumpet calls, so lift your voice. It's a year of jubilee, and God of Zion's hill, salvation comes. Behold, here he comes, riding on the clouds, shining like the sun, and the trumpet calls, so lift your voice. It's a year of jubilee, and God of Zion's hill.
That was lovely. Thank you. I lose my bulletin at this rate. At this time, Wanda, would you like to come forward and do the children's moment? Whichever one you want.
Good morning.
Good morning.
It's so good to see all of you. Well, today I brought me some M&Ms. And as you can see, there's multiple colors in there. And if we wanted to name them, there's orange and green and yellow and black. Some red and blue. And I just wonder why they made so many colors of M&Ms. The colored coating isn't flavored at all. The red isn't cherry or strawberry. The orange isn't orange. The blue isn't blue raspberry. The yellow isn't lemon. But the reason they made it is because it's exciting to eat. Me, I like to dump all mine out and line all the colors up. Eat one row of blue and then the red. I don't know why, it's just fun that way. And it's not because it's gonna mix up the flavors, because again, the colored coatings doesn't have any flavors. The reason I eat M&Ms is because of what's inside. Chocolate, my favorite food. God makes people in different colors also. We have red people, yellow people, black people, white people. God did that so we would live an exciting world. Could you imagine seeing a million Rhondas? Oh my word, thank God we don't, right? Okay, so he made us all a little bit different. bet we're all the same inside. Just like the M&Ms are chocolate inside, we are filled with a heart to love and a mind to think. And God wants us to go out there and He wants to use our hearts and our minds that we would make a better place to live. In Philippians 4:7, it says, "And the peace of God, which transcends all understanding, will guard your hearts and your mind in Christ Jesus." So let's go out. We can be a different M&M color, but let's love with our hearts and think with our minds.
Thank you, Rhonda. Mm-hmm.
And I have a sample if everybody wants.
All right, we have samples too. You can line them up in a row and eat them all at once too. She was thinking ahead. So if you want some M&Ms, she has snack packs over there.
Bill said he'll take all the W's.
Okay. before we go to the Word, would you please pray with me? God of life, by the power of your Spirit, come to us now. Plow our hearts with your living word until we are broken and become fertile with your love. For we long to bear fruit in a world that is wasting. Speak to us, Lord. We, your servants, are listening. Amen. Our first scripture comes from Psalm 119. Very short, just verse 105. It's a very important verse. You hear songs even written about it. Your word is a lamp to my feet and a light to my path. Then we move to Genesis. Genesis 25, verse 21, and then 24 through 33. Isaac prayed to the Lord for his wife because she was barren, and the Lord granted his prayer, and his wife Rebekah conceived. When her time to give birth was at hand, there were twins in her tomb, in her womb. The first came out red, all his body like a hairy mantle, so they named him Esau. Afterward, his brother came out with his hand gripping Esau's heel, so he was named Jacob. Isaac was 60 years old when she bore them. When the boys grew up, Esau was a skilled hunter and a man of the field, while Jacob was a quiet man living in the tents. Isaac loved Esau because he was fond of game, but Rebekah loved Jacob. Once when Jacob was cooking a stew, Esau came in from the field and he was famished. Esau said to Jacob, "Let me eat some of that red stuff, for I am famished." Therefore he was called Edom. Jacob said, "First, sell me your birthright." Esau said, "I am about to die. Of what use is a birthright to me?" Jacob said, "Swear to me first." So he swore to him and sold his birthright to Jacob. The word of God for the people of God. Thanks be to God. Are we doing a prayer hymn?
Join me as we sing Spirit of the Living God.
Spirit of the Living God, fall.
I need to get out of the sun, so I have to scoot over here. Now, we're going to have the message in two parts today. First part, I want to talk to you about Jacob and Esau, because that entire story is very interesting to me. The second part, I'll be turning it over to Jimmy, because it just happens to be that this last week, Jimmy had something that happened to him that we wanted to share, and it fit right in with the story. So you hear from me just a short while, then you'll get to hear from Jimmy. He has a personal testimony. You see, we only read a small part of the story of Jacob and Esau. And I'll be honest, I always felt like Esau got villainized unnecessarily many times. You gotta remember, they were born seconds apart. As Esau was coming out, they saw Jacob's hand on his heel coming right behind him. It didn't matter that they were twins. In the culture of that day, the firstborn had a birthright. Now, there's several parts to a birthright that we don't quite understand because we don't have that here, okay? But a birthright meant, first of all, you got a double portion of the inheritance when your father died. But you got a double portion. So since they were twins, this meant Esau would have got 2/3 of everything his father owned, but Jacob would only got 1/3. It also meant that you would be the head of the family. You made decisions for the entire family. You were also the spiritual leader of the family. It also meant you had some power, because sometimes you would have to negotiate with other tribes or groups, and you would be the spokesperson. Esau really didn't care about that too much, but Jacob did. And as you saw in our scripture today, he went out of his way to take that from Esau. He actually robbed him of it willingly, but he waited until he was weak and then bartered with him to take that birthright. Sorry, allergies. Normally I wear a mask outside and it's getting to me now. Anyway, but then chapters later in Genesis, and I didn't read this part, but many of you know the story. Later on, Jacob and Rebekah set up a deceitful scheme so that not only does Jacob have the birthright, that he gets his blessing from his father. Now, Esau didn't get real upset when he took the power, the money, the leadership, the spiritual power. He didn't get too upset about that. But when he took his blessing, that's when he had taken it too far, because he had dressed up as Esau and took his blessing. So he had robbed him of that blessing. And that really bothered him to the point that he was considering killing his brother. And that's why Jacob, if you read the rest of Genesis, that section, Jacob flees, saying that he's going to go find a wife. Actually, he's trying to get out of town so his brother doesn't kill him. And he's gone like 20 years. Now, it seems appropriate. This is one of those times, you know, we have this in our lives where we really so wish someone would get what they deserve. Jacob got what he deserved. He flees, goes to another part of the country with Rebecca's family, and guess what happens? Rebecca's brother just cheats him and cheats him and cheats him again, so the tables got turned on him. It eventually got to the point that Jacob decided he was better off going home and facing his brother than continuing where he was. Now, like I said, almost 20 years have passed. This had to be scary for him, but he didn't know what had happened in Esau's life during this time. And what does he find? As he's coming home, he keeps sending gift after gift ahead of him. He even has his people positioned so that part of them could flee in case Esau comes to attack them. But what he receives is a warm welcome. His brother looks at him and says, "I don't need your gifts. I'm just glad to see you." I love that even in Genesis, we see that Esau taught Jacob what grace was. he taught him what unmerited favor looked like. And what I love about when you read the Bible, you need to remember, people are watching. They had to be watching. How would you document it all? And they saw. I'm glad I'm almost done. My throat's scratchy. They saw what grace looked like. And you know, you can see that Esau trusted. He didn't need the birthright. He didn't need all those things. God still provided. Jacob was a taker. He just kept taking and taking and taking wherever he went. And I can't help but think that had an impact on him, that here he came, for once not wanting to take from his brother, wanting to give to his brother, and his brother didn't care. He was just so glad to see him. Because people look for our reaction to see, do we really trust God? Do we trust God to provide? Well, Jimmy had something happen to him recently, and he and I talked about it, and I said, I think that was a really good thing to share, and it worked out that this week we could share it. So I'm gonna let him share a personal testimony of how he is different now, just like Esau was different 20 years later. He didn't care to kill his brother anymore. He didn't care that he was a taker. He loved him in spite of that. So Jimmy, handing it over to you, and let my scratchy throat take a rest.
Good morning.
Good morning. You almost have to eat it.
Okay, I got it. Okay. I just want to start off by saying God's good. You know, amen. This last week, I went to a CR meeting. And while I was at that CR meeting, somebody had came in my house and took something from me. And a year ago, before I've found myself closer to God, I would have been kicking down people's doors. I'd have been pointing fingers at the wrong people. And it's hard telling what would have actually happened. You know, I'd have been out for vengeance. But instead, God gave me the grace to just let it go. You know, and it evidently they needed it more than I did. It didn't bother me as bad. But where God is good is, within an hour of me posting that post, and at the end, I just, instead of being mad, I just said, I find out who you are, I'm just going to pray for you. You know, and before, if I found out who you are, well, we was going to have a problem. But I just said I was going to pray for you. And within an hour of that post, half my money was returned, not by the people that took it, by people that had seen me changed, and God willing, brought them to me. And actually, I could have probably tripled the money that was taken. But I didn't know. I ended up having to actually argue with a few people, telling them I didn't need the money. You know, I got enough money to make it through the week now, and I don't need it, you know. And I had to argue with one friend of mine that he was bound determined he was going to come drop money off to me because I've helped them out so many times and stuff. But that just shows me how God is working through me, you know. And I'm grateful for it because, like I said, years ago, I'd have been mad. I'd have been looking for revenge. But instead, God touched my heart and just gave me grace and mercy. And if that person, if I find out who it was, they could come to me, I'd help them out again today. You know, I probably never will find out who it was, but that's all right. It ain't going to change the person that I am because of something that's happened, you know. And that's another thing. It kind of irritated me, though, because the person would have just came to me and told me that they needed it. Anybody that knows me knows I'd have just gave it to them. But that's my testimony and on how God's working through me. And like Emmanuel, he gave me mercy and grace upon the people that have taken from me. And it is, you know, I just hope that we all can pray for them. And I just want to say God's good and He's doing a lot of work through me, and I am very grateful for that. And I thank you for letting me share today.
Amen. Well, like you said, God is good. And I think sometimes we forget that grace that we've received. that when we extend it to other people, how that speaks volumes, because they see how we reacted to what happened to us. And we're not living in a world that takes things from people easily without hurting, and people don't handle it well. And I just thought that was an excellent, and the great thing is you put it on Facebook, that person probably has seen it. And they realize that Jimmy has said, I'm praying for you, and you know what? If you come again to my door, I'll still help you out, even though you took from me. Kind of like Esau said, I don't care that you've taken from me, you're still my brother and I love you. And that's what you say a lot, you're still my brother, you're still my sister, and I still love you. So I thought it was just an excellent testimony today. So if you don't mind, I would like to close in prayer, and then we can go do the final song. Because I think we have a hurting world that needs to hear and see that grace. So would you please pray with me? Gracious Heavenly Father, in our lives, each of us have encountered someone who has taken from us, sometimes taken something from us so valuable, it impacted us negatively for days, years, months. So today, Lord, we pray for all those people in the world who feel the only way they can get ahead is to take instead of asking. And Lord, we lift up all the Christians out here in the world. Remind them and us that when that happens, sometimes we just need to extend the same grace that you extended to us when we were taking, or we were not the people we should be. Because that's how we'll transform this world, just as Jimmy has been transformed. May we all work to transform this world so that we have disciple-making disciples everywhere we go. In Jesus' name, we humbly pray. Amen. And our final hymn is Shine, Jesus, Shine. Who wants to lead us? Please stand if you're able. Do you need to lead it?
We'll run everybody off, Mr. Mitchell.
Join me as we sing Shine, Jesus, Shine, and let your light shine before men.
Shine, Jesus, shine, fill this land with the Father's glory. Blaze, Spirit, blaze, set our hearts on fire. Flow, river, flow, flood the nations with grace and mercy. Send forth your word, Lord, and let there be light. Lord, the light of your love is shining in the midst of the darkness, shining. Jesus, light of the world, shine upon us, set us free by the truth you now bring us. Shine on me. Shine on me. Shine, Jesus, shine. Fill this land with the Father's glory. Blaze, Spirit, blaze. Set our hearts on fire. Flow, river, flow. Flood the nations with grace and mercy. Send forth your word, Lord, and let there be light.
Thank you. So as we go out into the world today, would you please stand for the benediction? You're already standing anyway, I guess. Put your arms out. You know, as we go out into the world, let's remember this grace we've been given. And it's not something we just hold on to ourselves. We extend it again and again and again. So as we go out, let's remember, people are watching how, as a Christian, we react to what happens to us, especially the takers of the world. And may we extend the grace we have been given. Amen. Thank you, everybody.